Clint Wise here with Freedom Realty Source, and we're going to be talking about looking at your home, your primary residence, as an investment property in today's 5-Minute Update. Hey everyone, alright, so I wanted to go over a couple of things here. As you're thinking about buying a primary residence, maybe you're a first-time home buyer, maybe you're buying your second or your third home, but there's just some things to think about that I wanted to bring to your attention when looking at a property as an investment. So a lot of people are told things like, you know, when you buy a home, you're making a great investment in purchasing your own home, you're building wealth, a new home is a wealth building tool, and it's a way that you can get rich, you're gonna be saving money on rent. You hear things like this all the time, especially from real estate agents, when they're talking to people who are primary renters that may be looking to buy that first home. A lot of people, you know, I've heard people say before, my grandparents bought a home back in 1960 for $15,000 and they just sold it last year for $225,000. And they walked away with, you know, $210,000. But you have to look at the fact that most people aren't going to own their home for 60 years. The average in the nation is 5 to 7 years people own a home. And you're just simply not going to make $200,000 on a home in an average of 6 years. It's just not gonna happen. So the realistic expectations have to be there. When you look at real estate booms and busts over the years, and the average equity growth over a 5 to 7 year period is about 3.5%. You may see a little bit more than that in hot markets like the Central Florida area, where you can see as much as 6% or so in equity growth. But by the time you factor in the cost of selling a home, having to pay doc stamps on the deed, title work, commissions, all that kind of stuff, you know, a lot of people, you know, by the time they walk away and they have enough money to put a down payment on another home, they're looking at just breaking even. And that's a very common occurrence when selling a home, when buying and selling houses. The key in all this is to have an agent who knows how to really find those good deals out there and who is not afraid to negotiate for you when you go to make an offer on a home. And also negotiating on the side of selling a home and making sure that you're getting top dollar when you're selling a house. The largest advantage that you have to look at when owning a home versus renting is, instead of renting and comparing, you know, you want to compare what type of home it is that you want. So if you're, you know, going into a home buying situation, you say, if I was going to rent, this is the home I want. And say the rent on that house is $2,000, right? $250,000 house, give or take. You're going to rent that home for $2,000. You could go and get the same exact $250,000 house and have a mortgage at around $1,800. Now you've just saved yourself $200 a month. Every single month, not only are you building equity in your own home, but you're saving $2,400, or rather earning $2,400 every year. You stay in that home for an average of 6 years, and now you've built up $14,000, $15,000, as long as you set that money back, on top of whatever equity you've gained in that home. And so that's where the real big difference is in renting versus buying your own home. It's just something to think about. With rent being a lot higher in most cases than actual mortgages, that's where you're going to see the really big differences in this, all right? It's a totally different scenario if you are going to live in your home for 20, 25 years. Of course, by that time, you're probably going to be really close to, if not paying off that mortgage. And so now you've got a real physical asset that you can sell, work that into your retirement plan, and walk away with, you know, $200,000, $250,000. So really just depends on what scenario you're looking at, but with most people staying in their homes for an average of 6 years, it's not going to be a wealth building tool, quote unquote. You will gain equity in that home, but the biggest difference is, instead of throwing the money away on rent on something that will never be yours, you're going to be able to pocket that money, set that aside in a money market or some type of savings plan that's going to earn you extra interest on that money. And not only will you walk away with equity, but you'll also walk away with that money as well. So I hope this guys helped you guys out. And if you have any questions about any of this, or you're looking to make an investment in your primary home and to stop throwing money away on renting, give me a call. I'm here to answer any questions that you might have at any time. I'd love to talk with you. Hope you guys have a great day. This has been your 5-Minute Update.